today is the theatrical trailer launch. So without much delay, sir, please announce it.
Yeah. Can we please have the trailer play out? And the real Azhar. You've seen the trailer. I hope you guys enjoyed it.
Azhar bhai, what led you to give us the green signal for this film? Why did you want us to make this?
That is a very tough ask. But actually, I really wanted to clarify the events which occurred in my life. Actually, the press has been calling it as a biopic, but I would like to stress that it is not a biopic. It is a film which is made on the events which have happened or occurred during my playing days at that point of time. Remember, I just wanted to clarify to the people that, you know, whatever has been said, you know, I've gone through a lot, you know, I mean, like, for so many years. It took 12 years to get to the case, and after that, when we won the case, then I thought when Ikka approached me, you know, first of all, I was not very sure about it, but then I think it took a lot of persuasion from a lot of people. Then I discussed with so many people. I discussed with one of my best friends here, Anshul bhai. I want to thank him also. I mean, he was very instrumental in me saying yes to that film.
And also, like you said, in 2011, the court gave you an acquittal.
2012.
Yes, 2012, yeah. They gave you the clean chit.
That's right.
But despite of that, there are still some critics and detractors. What would you want to tell them?
Well, I think you can't ask everyone to say good things about me. There are some people who are going to say things which are very ungainly or not very good to hear it. But I think it's part and parcel of life. You know, you have to take the good with the bad, and I think you have to move on.
Well, now I think we will call upon
The captain of the team, I think, Mr. Tony Anthony D'Souza. Without him, it would have been very, very difficult.
Hi. I've been a huge fan of Azhar bhai. I mean, known for quite some time. So when I got the offer of the film, I was very grateful to Ekta and Sneha for giving me the opportunity to make this movie. The person who's not here with us today is the person who actually written the script, Rajat Arora. Whatever you'll see and you'll like is thanks to him. I mean, he's worked the hardest and come up with a great script. I'd like to ask Azhar bhai to call the rest of the team on stage.
I think I'd like to call the two very pretty ladies, Prachi Desai and Nargis Fakhri. And I would like to call the most important lady who has taken me to the court, Lara Datta.
First, I think since Prachi came in earlier.
Okay. Hi, guys. It's really exciting being here. And I think we've all been huge fans of Azhar sir. So it's wonderful being a part of a film where I get to play a real-life character for the very first time for me. And I see Noreen as a very beautiful mystery that's going to unfold in front of you when you watch the film. So, yes, I hope you guys enjoy it just as much as I did. And I love the trailer. I hope you guys did.
Okay, I firstly have to apologize because I'm a little bit of a villain of the piece. So I think Tony couldn't find a villain, so I was made into one. I also think, I mean, this is my first film with Balaji, and of course my second with Tony, but my first with Imran. And I think at the end of this film, I am the only actress that he's worked with who he hasn't kissed. So,
the one that got away.
The one that got away.
No, that's the secret that they get to know only once the film releases.
Yeah, you never know. Yeah, there might be like never a surprise.
No. Would like to call Mr. Sameer Nair on the stage. Ekta Kapoor, the most important lady. Without these two ladies, it would have been very, very tough. Sir, I would like to call upon my son also who is here. I mean, he's been a very integral. Would like to call Nargis Fakhri also, please.
Wait for 2 minutes or?
No, we'll just wait, let's just open, yeah, we'll open up the house, please, for questions.
Can we play Oye Oye till then?
देखिए बहुत सारे चैलेंजेस थे जब हम रिसर्च कर रहे थे तो ऑब्वियसली जब फ़ोन कॉल आया जब एकता ने मुझे फ़ोन किया तो मुझे बहुत खुशी हुई कि इन पे फिल्म बन इनकी लाइफ में फिल्म बन रही है लेकिन तभी उसके बाद वो खुशी कहीं डर में बदल गई क्योंकि इनकी लाइफ इतनी इवेंटफुल रही है एक तो इम्बाइबिंग अ कैरेक्टर ऑन स्क्रीन जो फिल्म देखने वाले हैं जिस तरह बात करते हैं जिस तरह चलते हैं और जो मेन चीज़ थी वो थी उनकी क्रिकेटिंग स्किल्स क्योंकि मैं इतना अच्छा क्रिकेटर नहीं हूँ आई मीन हम सब इंडियंस हैं तो यहाँ पे बैट बॉल रख दो तो हम सब खेलें यू नो वी स्टार्ट प्लेइंग इट बट एक फॉर्म जो है एक टेक्निकलिटी जो है वो मुझ में नहीं था लेकिन अजहर भाई हैज़ बीन वेरी पेशेंट उन्होंने मुझे 2-3 महीने तक ट्रेनिंग दी एंड ही मेड इट अ लॉट ईजियर
अजहर सर
जी बोलिए
हेलो 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 अजहर सर आपसे सवाल है इधर आपके स्ट्रेट सीधा अजहर सर इधर
He's the one in the India.
Yes,
India.
Yes, India.
Yeah, T-shirt.
कहाँ पर? अच्छा, बहुत दूर है.
अच्छा सर, सबसे पहला सवाल आपसे है कि आप सफेद हेलमेट क्यों पहनते थे? इसका जवाब चाहिए. Secondly, एक सवाल और है कि एक शॉट आपका है जो आप फ्लिक करते थे क्या कहते हैं उसको? जो VVS लक्ष्मण भी खेलते हैं लेफ्ट लेग ड्राइव पे. तो वो शॉट आपने ट्रेलर में नहीं दिखाया हमें. तो वो शॉट क्या फिल्म में होगा आपके?
देखिए पहली बात तो वाइट हेलमेट इसलिए मैं पहनता था क्योंकि उस टाइम पे हमें जो भी हेलमेट मिलती थी हम पहन लेते थे पर उस टाइम पे कोई ऐसा रूल नहीं था कि ब्लू हेलमेट ही पहने या और कोई अलग हेलमेट पहने तो इसी वजह से मुझे सफ़ेद कलर अच्छा लगता था क्योंकि सफ़ेद कपड़े होते थे सफ़ेद जूता होता था सफ़ेद पहतावे होते सफ़ेद पैंट सफ़ेद ग्लव्स तो उसकी वजह से मैं सफ़ेद हेलमेट पहनता था बट लेकिन जो आप फ्लिक शॉट के जो बारे में बात कर रहे हैं मुझे याद नहीं है मैं मुझे कैसे खेलता था मुझे मैं तो भूल गया हूँ लेकिन आप जब फिल्म में देखेंगे तो शायद इमरान भाई मेरे से अच्छा खेल रहे हो
एक्चुअली वो फ्लिक शॉट है इट गोज बाय वेरी फास्ट टोनी यू सेकंड दैट अगर आप फास्ट कट्स देखें एंड में एंड ऑब्वियसली इन द फिल्म इट्स इट हैज अ बिट ऑफ लेंथ
इमरान यस इमरान यस ऑन योर लेफ्ट सॉरी इमरान टुवर्ड्स योर राइट
या
हाय यस हाय the trailer really looks amazing you know Thank it has you. A mix of everything basically what you all want to show through his life and through his journey till now
yes
what has been your family's reaction to the trailer to your look
well they're going to see it convincing? They're going to see everyone's going to see it soon but I'm sure they're going to love it because like you said it has everything in it it has you know the look of the film the emotion and this is where we were actually this was a huge responsibility on I think the entire team that we were putting his life down on celluloid and that's a huge responsibility eventually you know there is an audience for whom we're making the film but for me it would be a battle won if whenever Azhar bhai sees the film when the lights dim in the theater and he watches the film and he comes out and says you know you've done me proud and this is how I would envision my life that would be the best you know bit of praise that I can get for the film so I'm waiting for that day when he sees the first copy which will be out soon
Imran
I would like to call upon Nargis Fakhri on the stage please
Imran
What was that one lesson you learned from Azhar's life?
I think apart from the film, it's just when I met him. Obviously, I have idolized him for the longest time. You know, I'd seen him in the 80s and 90s. And what struck me when I met him, and you know, we were doing the research, and I had actually compiled 100 questions for him. And I used to keep bugging him every day with these questions. And I just felt that here there was a man who was extremely frank about the way he has been, he's led his life. And, you know, it's just sometimes you want to see yourself the way you want to see yourself, not in reality. And he was extremely cordial. He was extremely frank about those things, and a very, very sensitive person. Those are the things I admire about Azhar Bhai. And I've spent a lot of time with him over the past 1.5 year. And a lot of things can be said, but these are the two things: a very frank person and a very sensitive person.
And any similarity you find between you and Azhar Bhai?
Well, I've tried to imbibe the similarities. I don't know.
Flick shot.
That was the toughest, actually. My wrists, I had to ice them every day because it was very tough. I used to work out, I used to lift weights, and because Azhar Bhai used to not lift weights. He said that he's against that
when you
were playing at that time. And there was a certain agility and the flexibility, so I had to like detrain for like 3 months and just train to get that flick shot. So it took me 4 months to get that. So it was almost a choreographed action, and we eventually got it.
Hi.
I think it's been pretty long time now, so I don't blame anybody. I think that it was destiny which had me on the mat. But anyways, to come out of that, you know, it was very, very pleasing. I was very happy for my family, for my son, my father, my mother, everybody, and all the fans, all the people who really, helped me in whatever way they can. They came in hordes to watch the matches, and I think I felt that, you know, it was the right thing when I went to the court when we won the case. That was icing on the cake. Imran shares seasoning chemistry with everybody.
I sizzle with everyone.
There's not a problem. There's nothing new for him. Ask me something new. Well, I think with Imran Hashmi, actually it's not a love-making scene. You know, it was and pretty, I think it was a very tough thing to say. But it is with Imran Hashmi. You expect that. You know, if you go there and Imran Hashmi is not doing that, I mean, you will come out very disappointed.
Hi, Ekta.
Don't you reckon?
Hi, Ekta, over here, towards your right. Ekta, towards your right, over here. You know, many players towards your right over here. You know, are you planning to keep a special screening of the film for the cricket team or the players who? Played under Azhar, sir?
So, that's completely going to be decided later. But I'm sure we will show a lot of players the film because it's quite a celebration not only of cricket, but of what happens when you are doing so well and suppose one game goes wrong, you get blamed for so many things. So, yeah, a lot of cricketers will be seeing the film. But many don't want to see the film. I think many would not want to see the film. So, yeah, that will be there too.
Antonio, you know, many other players were involved in this scandal. So, how much of importance has been given to them, their characters?
I think it's better that you watch the film and ask this question. I mean, we've gone, as he said, it is not a biopic, but we based on facts and events that happened in life. So, we've tried to go close to a lot of things, but there is certain cinematic liberty we've taken too.
Hi, Azhar.
But have you fictionalized the events? Is there anything fiction or?
See the movie. It'll make no sense that way.
Hi, Azhar.
देखिए मैं सबसे बात करके इस डिसीजन लिया कभी अकेला डिसीजन लेना देखिए बहुत मुश्किल होता है तो मैं कैप्टन हूँ तो मैं पूरे 11 लोगों का पूरा व्यू पॉइंट लेके देख के उनसे बात करके तो जब भी डिसीजन लेना था आपको याद होगा कि 93 वर्ल्ड हीरो कप में हम लोग जब ने मैच साउथ अफ्रीका के साथ जीता था तो हमारी आप देखे थे लास्ट ओवर था 5 रन बाकी थे तो हमारी पूरी टीम जमा हो गई थी पूरी टीम का डिसीजन था कि तेंदुलकर बॉलिंग करना तो तेंदुलकर ने बॉलिंग किया तो मैं समझता हूँ कि सभी से एडवाइस लिया हूँ मैं तो इसी वजह से आज ये फिल्म
हाय स्नेहा मेरा सवाल आपसे है कि आप आईपीएल के भी ब्रॉडकास्टर हैं तो इस फिल्म को आईपीएल के दौरान भी प्रमोट किया जाएगा वेल कॉन्वर्सेशन जो होते हैं बीच में
जी बिल्कुल
तो क्या प्लानिंग है एग्जैक्टली किस तरीके से प्रमोट करेंगे
वॉच द आईपीएल यू विल सी
ओके इमरान यही ऑडी था जहां से शुरुआत हुई थी आई थिंक 6-8 महीने पहले जब पहला एक टीजर छोड़ा गया
जी जी
तब से लेकर के अभी तक का सफर जरा अगर आप बताएं कि किस तरीके से ओवरऑल क्योंकि आपने आईएसडी भी शूटिंग की है एसटीडी लोकल भी
आईएसडी ज्यादा शूटिंग की है बट एक बहुत ही टफ जर्नी रहा है क्योंकि तभी तो हमने सिर्फ वॉक शूट किया था और बैक टू कैमरा शॉट था लेकिन उसके बाद वी केम डाउन टू एक्चुअली शूटिंग और हमने लंदन में शूटिंग की एच बेस्ट इन दाबिशा हैदराबाद में जो इनका होम टाउन है तो बहुत नर्वस था मैं क्योंकि यू नो क्रिकेटिंग पोर्शंस ऑब्वियसली वर मेड मी द मोस्ट नर्वस क्योंकि सब लोगों ने अजहर भाई को देखा है उनके मैनरिज्म्स हैं ऑन द फील्ड उनके न्यूएंसेस हैं तो उन चीज़ों को एम्बाइब करना एंड अगर इस फिल्म में अगर आपने कुछ गलत कर दिया तो एक तरह से एक बहुत ही ज़्यादा क्रिटिसिज्म हो सकता है तो उस चीज़ को दिमाग में रखकर नोटिंग वेरी वेरी माइन्यूट थिंग्स अबाउट अजहर भाई फ्रॉम द वॉक टू द वे ही यूज्ड टू ईट द वे ही यूज्ड टू स्पीक तो ये सब चीज़ें मैंने इम्बाइब करनी शुरू की ही हार्डली एट दैट्स व्हाई आई एम हार्डली ईटिंग इन द फिल्म ऑल्सो बट आई यूज्ड टू आई ऑलमोस्ट बिकेम अ स्टॉकर यू नो व्हेन वी वर एक्चुअली प्लेइंग क्रिकेट आई थिंक ही कॉट मी स्टेयरिंग एट हिम ईरली and trying to just see what you know everything every nuance so I think I made his life hell for those 3-4 months
ek khas lehja bhi hai hyderabad ka jo trailer mein sunai
ji isme hai portions mein hai jo jab hyderabad ka portion hai is film mein jo unke childhood se lekar jab wo 20 ke the 21 the to wo portion mein thoda zyada lehja hai
hyderabad nargis saab ne wo oye wala gana suna tha pehle aap agar hindi mein
suna yes I have
तो उस समय और इस समय क्या क्या डिफरेंसेस अगर आप बता सके ऑन योर राइट
सॉरी व्हाट डिड यू से अगेन
मैंने हिंदी में पूछा कि उस गाने में इस गाने में कितना परिवर्तन है तब्दीलियां हैं
व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस एज इन वॉच द फिल्म एंड यू विल फाइंड आउट वेरी गुड थैंक यू मैं
सब कुछ अगर फिल्म देख के ही पता करेंगे तो फिर आज कुछ आपसे भी तो पूछना चाहेंगे
हाय टोनी मेरा सवाल आपसे है आप इस टैगलाइन पे फोकस करेंगे लव हिम हेट हिम जज हिम इट्स जनरली लव मी हेट मी डू नॉट जज मी तो जज हिम आल्सो है साथ
हां जज हिम बिकॉज़ अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल स्टिल थिंक दैट अ लॉट ऑफ नॉट अवेयर ऑफ द वर्डिक्ट ऑफ द कोर्ट सो द आईडिया वाज टू पोर्ट्रे व्हाट इज द फैक्ट एक्चुअली हैपेंड विद द कोर्ट सो वी आर होपिंग दैट पीपल सी एंड दे जज हिम द वे दे शुड जज हिम आफ्टर द फिल्म
टैगलाइन की बात कर रहे थे तो आपसे जानना चाहेंगे लव हिम हेट हिम जज हिम ये जहन में कौन सी बात आती है जब ये टैगलाइन आपको सुनाया गया या आप जब आप सुनते हैं
लव हिम ही आएगी और दूसरी तो कोई दिमाग में आ रही नहीं आपने इतना
इमरान जन्नत
सवाल था
इमरान आपने जन्नत में मैच फिक्सिंग का रोल किया था अभी आप रियल लाइफ हीरो का रोल प्ले कर रहे हैं तो आपकी लाइफ में क्रिकेट कितना इंपॉर्टेंट है
वेल बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट रहा है यू नो आई हैव ग्रोन अप वाचिंग अजहर भाई इन द 80s 90s जब वो कैप्टन थे एंड आई थिंक दोज वर द ग्लोरी डेज ऑफ क्रिकेट क्योंकि तभी ज़्यादा फॉर्म्स भी नहीं थे एंटरटेनमेंट के एंड व्हेनेवर योर फैमिली यूज़ टू सिट एंड वॉच देयर वाज दिस वेरी कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड अप्रोच एवरीवन यूज़ टू सिट एंड वॉच द मैच ज़्यादा इंटरनेट नहीं था ज़्यादा प्रोग्राम्स नहीं थे सो इट वॉज जस्ट अ ग्रेट टाइम फॉर क्रिकेट और जब इंडिया और पाकिस्तान के मैचेस भी हुआ करते थे इट वॉज जस्ट वेरी वेरी एंटरटेनिंग सो दोज आर द मेमरीज ऑफ क्रिकेट एंड ऑब्वियसली क्रिकेट इज स्टिल ग्रेट but I was very honored jab mujhe ye role mila to portray his life
Imran, there were reports that your family was not happy with the first poster
no that's not true like I gave the quote today maybe it was misconstrued when I said they were shocked that doesn't mean they didn't like it they were surprised and in a nice way because that's what I my wife told me in the morning she loved the poster she found it very unique and she said she definitely wants to see the film
इंडियन टीम की ब्लू जर्सी पहनने के बाद क्या कुछ महसूस कर रहे थे आप
वेरी प्राउड
इमरान हियर इमरान व्हेन दिस मैच फिक्सिंग स्कैंडल ब्रोक आउट वे बैक इन द 90s एंड व्हेन अजहर भाई'स नेम गॉट एम्ब्रॉयल्ड इन इट व्हाट वाज योर रिएक्शन डिड यू एट दैट टाइम बिलीव दैट अजहर इज इनोसेंट
नो आई डिडंट यू सी द थिंग इज देयर इज ऑब्वियसली देयर वर फैंस ऑफ अजहर भाई दैट गेव हिम द सपोर्ट दैट ही ऑब्वियसली डिजर्व्ड दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम There are also certain people that like to jump the gun and play judge, jury and executioner when they say that, okay, probably he has done it. But they didn't even follow the court case. And eventually, it was kind of a vindication when he won the court case. So I believe in following
a certain, you know, the way the law has to function, let it take its course. And that happens not just with him. It's happened with every celebrity, every sports person around the world. You know, it's very high profile, and people do reach their own judgment, which I think is extremely unfair. You should let the court have its hearing and then decide. We might not agree with the court's verdict, but we have to accept it.
Azhar, cricket and Bollywood often go hand in hand with each other. We have seen many cricketers date Bollywood actors. One person who has been at the receiving end for dating a Bollywood actress is Virat Kohli, whose failure sometimes gets his girlfriend to the picture, and criticism happens on social media. What would your advice be to him? How should he tackle it? How should he react to it?
I think the press should tackle better than what Virat Kohli should tackle, because I think this is personal life, you know, because you cannot really... talk about all those things, you know, because I think he's performing well on the field. And as a player, you know, you really have to really look at what he's doing as a cricketer. I mean, his performance has been outstanding. And I think whatever he does in his private life, I think you have to leave it to him, you know, because sometimes we get too judgmental, and then, I think that's what happened. I think if the things are true that there's some problem in the relationship, I think it's because of the tough time which is posed by the press to them.
Hi, Tony. Gaurav from Midday. I have two questions, one for you, one for Imran. On to your right, here, on the stairs. So, the first question is, you have said the film is based on the facts and, you know, whatever it's been reported around Azhar Bhai. There are a lot of reports about, you know, players, basically team players revolting against him, or the fights between him and the other players. And also about the political career which he had. So are we just going to see the controversial side of it, or just the fixing side of it, or will there be some glimpses of all these things? And second question is for Imran. So if you want to answer this first.
Yeah, I think everyone talks only about the fixing. There's a lot more to his life than just fixing. I mean, he's the only person to score 100 in the first and last match, 300 in a row. We got to celebrate him as a cricketer also. So the film is not only about a certain aspect in his life, it's the entire journey of life which has happened. As far as players who didn't support him or supported him, I think the film answers all that.
And for Imran, who do you think is the best captain for Team India?
He's standing right here.
Thank you.
Imran, towards your left.
A little later.
Imran, towards your left. Mera sawal aapse is trailer launch se thoda hatkar hai. Aapki close friend Kangna, she is celebrating the national award, but off late unki personal life ko lekar kafi kuch.
Can we just keep it to the film, please?
Just wanted to get your view, because
too many personal lives are being spoken about.
One on one, we'll do it. Yeah?
Okay. Hi, Nargis.
Hi.
Loud. No, unfortunately, I didn't get to meet Sangeeta, but I did watch her films, and with the help of the team here, I learned about the stories that went on. And of course, we have the internet, so I can research now, which I love the internet. So I used all of that to imbibe her character. Oh, I did my best. I hope I did. All right. Yeah. Let's
see. Hi, Prachi.
Yeah, her Hindi's very good. Mine is not.
Her Hindi is also very good.
It's okay. Prachi, yahan pe.
I want to understand. Yeah, what I want to understand.
Left side.
My left.
Right side. Sorry. Yahan saamne.
Hi.
Hi, Anugya, News Online se. Mera sawal ye hai ki aap Azhar ji ki first drive se mile the. Aapko jab ye role diya gaya tha. Aur ye second film hai aapki Imran ji ke saath.
Yeah, it only gets better. जी मैं मिली हूँ नौरीन से एंड एक्चुअली ऑनेस्टली पहले मेरे लिए आई थिंक इट वाज अ लिटिल स्कैरी व्हेन आई गॉट टू नो दैट आई हैव टू प्ले नौरीन बिकॉज उनके बारे में कोई भी इंफॉर्मेशन कहीं पर अवेलेबल नहीं है सो यू नो आई हैड टू कम्प्लीटली रिलाई ऑन द सोर्सेस थ्रू ऑफकोर्स टोनी वट एवर दैट आई गॉट टू नो अबाउट हर बट उनसे मिलने के बाद ऑनेस्टली मेरे जितने भी प्रिजम्पशंस थे इट जस्ट गॉट क्लियर लाइक कम्प्लीटली एब्सोल्युटली So I think after meeting her, I'm completely in awe with her. I think she's way more a lovely person than I imagined her to be. Mm-hmm. And unki jitne bhi characteristics hai, I tried to imbibe them in the film. I mean, bahut sari cheeze thi jo mujhe lagi ki जैसे मुझे बोला गया था कि वो बहुत आई थिंक शाय है, बहुत कम बोलते हैं, मगर ऐसा नहीं है. आई थिंक शी हैज़ अ ब्यूटिफुल गेज व्हेन शी टॉक्स एंड देर वर लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स दैट आई ऑब्जर्व, सो आई एम वेरी ग्लैड दैट आई एक्चुअली गॉट टू मीट हर. एंड या
आपकी सेकंड फिल्म है ये इमरान जी के साथ
जी,
तो कुछ एक्सपीरियंस शेयर करना चाहेंगी? ऑन सेट कैसे रहते हैं अजहर जी, ऑन स्क्रीन अजहर जी?
ऑन स्क्रीन के जो अजहर हैं, आई थिंक ही प्लेस क्रिकेट गॉर्जियसली नाउ, एंड आई जस्ट थिंक दिस फिल्म, हिज परफॉर्मेंस इन दिस फिल्म इज गोइंग टू ब्लो योर माइंड एब्सोल्युटली. एंड उनके साथ काम करके दिस एक्सपीरियंस वॉज इवन बेटर, बिकॉज उनका जो सेंस ऑफ ह्यूमर है और नास्टी हो गया है, सो इट वॉज अ लॉट ऑफ फन एक्चुअली शूटिंग विद हिम. या
मेरा सवाल अजहर जी से है, जब आपका बुरा हेलो जब मतलब आप बोलते ना सफलता के समय तो सब साथ होते हैं, लेकिन जब आपका बुरा वक्त चल रहा था तो किस क्रिकेटर ने आपको सपोर्ट किया और उनको आप पे विश्वास था या कोई और पर्सन?
देखिए तीन लोग ऐसे थे जो मुझे टोटल सपोर्ट मिला, जो राज सिंह साहब, जो मेरे ख्याल में राज सिंह दंगरपुर साहब जो प्रेसिडेंट थे बोर्ड के, उन्होंने बहुत मुझे सपोर्ट किया, और कमल मुरारका साहब ने भी बहुत मुझे सपोर्ट किया, और क्रिकेटर्स में कपिल पाजी ने सब में ज़्यादा मुझे सपोर्ट किया. तो मैं समझता हूँ ये तीन लोग उस वक्त में मुझे बहुत बहुत सपोर्ट किया, और मैं उनका बहुत बहुत शुक्रगुजार हूँ. मैं अगर कितना भी शुक्रिया अदा करूँ, मैंने समझता हूँ कि उनका शुक्रिया अदा कर सकूँगा, क्योंकि उस वक्त बहुत टफ था, बहुत से लोग अगेंस्ट भी बोल रहे थे, बहुत से लोग अलग अलग किस्म की बातें हो रही थी, बट लेकिन ये तीन लोग ने मुझे सपोर्ट किया, मैं उनका बहुत शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ. और जो लोग सपोर्ट नहीं किया, देखिए ये तो अपना हर आदमी का एक पर्सनल नज़रिया होता है, और मैं समझता हूँ उसको वहीं पे छोड़ देना चाहिए.
और घर पे घर पे किसका सपोर्ट था आपको?
घर में तो पूरे जन सपोर्ट करेंगे,
सभी सपोर्ट,
घर तो ये तो बहुत आसान था.
और इमरान जी आपको ये रोल जब मिला तो आपकी नींद उड़ गई कि मुझे अभी परफेक्ट दिखना है हजरत जी के जैसे?
जी डेफिनेटली, जैसे मैंने कहा कि इस फिल्म के लिए जब सब लोगों ने अजहर भाई को स्टडी किया 80s और 90s जब भी खेल रहे थे, मैंने भी स्टडी किया, तो अगर क्रिटिसिज्म आना है तो एक बहुत ही बड़ा क्रिटिसिज्म आ सकता है, तो लेकिन पूरी टीम का सपोर्ट था. आई वुडंट से आई हैव डन दिस ऑन माय ओन, बहुत सारे लोग थे, हमारी पूरी डायरेक्शन डिपार्टमेंट, द प्रोडक्शन, द कॉस्ट्यूम्स, ऑल दीज थिंग्स हेल्प. और ऑब्वियसली जब ट्रेन कर रहे थे तो अजहर भाई भी थे, तो बहुत लोगों ने मेहनत की मेरे साथ, एंड इवेंचुअली आपको दिख रहा है स्क्रीन पर. और ऑब्वियसली अब फिल्म देखेंगे तो आप वर्डिक्ट देंगे.
और एकता जी से मेरा सवाल है कि आपने इमरान जी को ही क्यों चुना इस रोल के लिए? मतलब इतने सारे इमेज के खिलाफ, मतलब खिलाफ जाके आपने चुना है, उनकी जो इमेज है तो कुछ खास दिखा आपने?
आई थिंक इमरान इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट अमेजिंग एक्टर्स आई वर्क विद, बहुत अच्छे उम्दा इंसान है, और एक कंट्रोवर्शियल येट गुड हार्टेड क्रिकेटर का रोल अगर कोई कर सकता है, एंड हु हैज़ द मास इंडिया इवन टुडे इन लव विद हिम, इट वुड हैव बीन वन ऑफ द खान्स और इमरान, सो वी चोज इमरान.
टोनी
I think it's a bit of a blessing, but as well as a backstep, because at the end of the day, everybody has references to draw, and I didn't. But I know at the end of the day, I'm playing a prosecuting lawyer, and we were talking about Imran's sizzling chemistry with all the women, so I think I'm the only one who took him literally from the frying pan into the fire in this film. So sizzling, he's really felt. It's come from this way. I think Tony helped a lot. We went over a lot of the information that related to the case. We really sat down and observed people within the profession. And, you know, I had a very clear character graph to play. Like I said, I literally do play a capital word that you don't say in public but starts with a B. And, so she is somebody who is very sort of hard-hitting. And I think it was more challenging for me because she asked the questions that I think millions of Indian fans want to ask of Azhar. So through this film, she's that voice. And that was a huge responsibility.
Tony, trailer mein ek scene hai. Excuse me. टोनी, इसमें एक सीन है जिसमें पाकिस्तान की टीम को आपने दिखाया है कि इधर आजा भाई, तो कहते मेरे नाम में मोहम्मद है, तो कहीं ना कहीं ऐसा नहीं लग रहा पाकिस्तानी टीम की नाराजगी झेलनी पड़ सकती है और मैदान का एक दिखाने की कोशिश हुई है?
नहीं, मैं नहीं मानता हूँ. मैं पाकिस्तान का भी फैन हूँ ऑन द क्रिकेट फील्ड, तो मैं ये नहीं चाहूंगा कि कोई हमसे नाराज हो, बट इट्स ऑल इन गुड ह्यूमर।
हाय लारा, लारा आपने आती मेंशन किया कि आप इमरान हाशमी की इकलौती ऐसी हीरोइन है जिन्हें उन्होंने किस नहीं किया है, आप खुश हैं या दुखी हैं?
नो नो, आई एम क्वाइट ऑल राइट।
आप उनके हस्बैंड से पूछिए।
एग्जैक्टली, यू हैव समथिंग टू लुक फॉरवर्ड टू राइट इन फ्यूचर फिल्म्स दैट यू डू, सो वी विल सी।
इमरान हाशमी साहब की तो कलरफुल कहानी है इनकी, आपको तो पता है।
इमरान अज़र भाई,
सीन बहुत अच्छे रहेंगे।
अज़र भाई, इमरान
अज़र टुवर्ड्स योर राइट,
अज़र का तो ट्रेलर हमने सबने देखा, सबको पसंद आया, बट साथ ही में सुशांत सिंह स्टारर एमएस धोनी बायोपिक भी रिलीज हो रही है, तो कह सकते हैं एक ही जो क्रिकेटर के लाइफ पर बेस्ड फिल्में हैं दो आ रही हैं, तो कंपटीशन हो सकता है आपस में?
देखिए कंपटीशन, देखिए वो अलग फिल्म है, ये अलग फिल्म है, ठीक है, बिल्कुल अब कंपैरिजन नहीं कर सकते। मैं जहाँ तक मैं सोचता हूँ कि कंपैरिजन नहीं होनी चाहिए, बिकॉज देखिए उन्होंने अपनी फिल्म बना रहे, हम हमारी फिल्म बनाए, तो हम हमारी फिल्म के बारे में बात करेंगे ताकि उनकी फिल्म।
अज़र, अज़र टुवर्ड्स योर राइट, अज़र योर दिस ईयर एज वी हैव टू बायोपिक्स यू नो ऑन क्रिकेटर्स, ऑन यू एंड देन वी हैव ऑन एमएस धोनी, एनी अदर क्रिकेटर हुज लाइफ यू थिंक कैन बी एन इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग टू वॉच, मे बी समवन ऑफ योर टाइम्स और फ्रॉम द करंट क्रॉप ऑफ क्रिकेटर्स?
आई एम नॉट थिंकिंग ऑन दोज लाइंस, सो इट्स वेरी हार्ड फॉर मी टू से आफ्टर माय दिस थिंग, यू नो इट्स वेरी हार्ड फॉर मी टू फाइंड आउट हुज लाइफ शुड बी शोन ऑन द स्क्रीन, आई रियली डोंट नो, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द इंडिविजुअल, यू नो टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट। नहीं देखिए आजकल बिल्कुल प्लेयर्स जिम्मेदार हैं, उन लोग को पता है क्या है कैसे अपने आप को बिहेव करना, तो मैं समझता हूँ मेरे को उतनी ज़्यादा कहने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ी।
एकता,
व्हाट वाज सो स्पेशल अबाउट दिस फिल्म दैट सोनिया एंड
जर्बियन? एंड माय क्रिकेट आल्सो। I think Hansi Grohny has passed away, so it is not very imperative for me to talk on those lines, you know, because I think he was a very outstanding player, you know, he's done so much for his country. I think he's still one of the most successful captains South Africa has ever produced. So I think may his soul rest in peace. That's what I can say, because it's not very easy for me to say on that count. Well, I'm sure you would have seen, you know, but I think on his live film, I mean, he had to decide, I mean, if he was alive, so. Well, you have to find out on those, you know, I can't reveal, I mean, like,
Ekta,
I really cannot reveal anything.
Sorry. Ekta, do you think Pakistan will release this film? Because there are references to Pakistan, and every time there is a reference to Pakistan, they get very jittery. Like, for instance, it happened in Nirja and a lot of other films. How do you see it?
So, every serial of mine releases in Pakistan and does better there. So I don't think there'll be a problem, because I don't think there's one reference against Pakistan. So except for what you saw in the promo, which is not really a reference against Pakistan, I think Pakistan will revel in this film, because it's about cricket and it's about a loved cricketer who's been loved universally.
Who is that Pakistani player who invites Azhar to get into
Manhattan? What? No. No. Yeah, no. Take this one.
समीर आप कुछ बताइए, आपकी क्या एक्सपेक्टेशन है फिल्म से?
वेल एक्चुअली एवरीथिंग अबाउट अज़र इज स्पेशल, आई मीन ही हैज बीन वन ऑफ इंडियाज़ फाइनेस्ट क्रिकेटर्स, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सक्सेसफुल कैप्टन्स, वी हैव ऑल बीन बिग फैंस ऑफ हिज, वी हैव ग्रोन अप सीइंग हिज मूवीज, Tony is a big fan of his, Imran is a big fan of his, and you know, if a movie has to be made, this is a story that has to be told, and that's what we are doing, we are telling that story, and it's the most exciting, interesting story. So I mean, I'm really happy that Balaji and Sony got together and got Tony and Imran and are telling others' life.
Uh,
Well, I think at that time I was supremely fit at that point of time. You know, when I played my last test match, you know, I must not be saying about myself, but I think I used to really compete with the people who are 10, 12 years younger than me. So maybe I could have played another couple of years, but I think 99 test matches, I don't think anybody would break that. Well, 99 test match, anybody can play. I'm not sure, maybe. I can't say.
Guys, last two questions, please, before we wrap up.
Of course, yes, of course. I've still not recovered from the loss last night. Well, I think it's going to be a very tough match. You know, I'd say 60-40 in favor of West Indies. I think after tomorrow is the game. I think West Indies really played well. You know, I think they deserved to be the winners last night.
Is that right? Okay, thank you, guys. Photo op now.
Mubarak.
Hello.
Nargis.
Nargis, left up, left.
Lekarna, you sure, na?
Samor, Samor.
So you're not doing it first?
Here we go. 5 minutes.
Wake up.
Silence, please.
Hi, we have. I like this square light. We have Imran.
Me 2 years back, and Ikta had called me up, and it was a brief conversation where she said that we are planning out a film based on the life of Muhammad Azharuddin. And I didn't think for a second. I said, I'm definitely doing it. I didn't hear the story out, because I followed him for those 15, 16 years when he was in our team, and when he was the captain of the Indian cricket team. And then after that, the unfortunate dark phase of Indian cricket and his life, when his name was taken, when there was the match-fixing allegation drawn on his name. So that was the conversation, and you know, after that we drafted the script. It took around a year after that, and we went on floors. Azharbhai actually had not okayed the script back then. He okayed it on the third draft, and then we finally went on floor and we shot the film. Well, you know, if you're doing a fictional film, there is 100 different ways you can play a character. But when you're playing a film based on someone's life, who's, you know, alive, flesh and blood, people have followed him, you have to be very accurate and as close to home as possible. But in a film of this nature, it was very essential to dramatize certain elements. There were the 4 or 5 songs. So yes, it has elements of being a biopic, but at the same time, it dramatizes some moments for our audience to kind of, you know, to entertain them, because as part of our culture, the songs have to be there. And, you know, there are dialogues that people are going to love in this film. So we've dramatized it, I would say, 10 to 20%, but most of it is things about cricket that all of you don't know, and that have been shared by Azharbhai with us. You know, they might have come out in the media, a lot of things, but not everything. So Azharbhai has shared those very, very intimate details about the sport and his life for this film. He's a fantastic person. He's got extreme amount of patience and inner strength to deal with the stuff that he went through in his life at that point of time. After, you know, being removed from the sport and the team, in year 2000, when he was at the top of his game, I think it takes a lot of courage and inner strength and patience to deal with what he had to deal with. Yeah, come. No, come. Kursiya lagya. I thought you guys were going to take like half an hour like before, so I said.
Yeah. Have you been having coffee?
No, slightly.
Yeah.
So do you believe that match-fixing is going on in the reality?
Well, I can't speak for a particular time in the sport, and at that time, you know, a lot of things were put forward. Eventually, it was the judicial system that had played out its, you know, the verdict, and he was acquitted of it. But sports around the world, you know, they have hi, how are you doing?
Hi.
They have allegations that have been attached to it of match fixing, and that is a fact. Now, I can't come down to telling you which players fix matches. I can't tell you which games have been fixed, because that, you know, anyone's guess. I said it.
Sir, does swing cricket or breakfast cricket was 30 years?
It was the toughest in this film, because coming very, you know, even close to the way Azharbhai used to play is extremely tough. You know, the most accomplished batsman was the highest run scorer at one point of time, and I was like an average to below average player. So not too much technicality, which was obviously thanks to Azharbhai. He taught me these things. I was more of an offside player. I had to play on the leg side because that's where Azharbhai was very strong. So it took me around 3-4 grilling months of training for cricket every day, 3 hours every day. So. Yeah, so that's, you know, that was the regime back then.
I am unfortunately the only one who has not met anyone, so I didn't get compliments
as yet.
As yet.
As yet.
Let's see.
To come soon.
To come soon. everyone, you know, really enjoyed it. I liked it. I think they remixed it really well and made it more dancey and modern. So.
I play Noreen in the film. Noreen was Azhar's first wife. I think she was barely 16 when they got married. It was an arranged marriage. I think that's a side, that's a part of Azhar's life that not many know about. They do know that she was his first wife, but nothing more than that. So in this film, I think you get to, you know, see that part of his life. And I think the way it's been treated, and I just feel like everybody's going to be able to connect to it, because I did in a big way. And a lot many things actually about their relationship, about the 9 years of their marriage, which of course, like I said, nobody knows much about. I think that you get to see in the film.
This is your second film.
Am I afraid of him? Yeah, you know, I usually don't sit this close to Imran. I'm a little scared. I'm afraid of Imran. Okay, no. Am I still afraid of him? That's your question.
He's been calling interviews since then.
Okay, we're kidding. We're kidding. This happens after too many interviews. This is what happens. This is my second film with Imran, and it was a great experience. I think the familiarity really helped both of us, because yes, we play these real life characters. I think it was extremely tough for Imran to play Azhar for a lot many reasons. I mean, I know how hard he worked on this film, and Noreen for me. So just the fact that we were familiar with each other, we share a great rapport, all of that really made it much easier for both of us. And I had a great great experience working with him again.
Yeah, I mean, this is a trend that actually started off a couple of years back. I keep saying this, you know, the films here are, in the traditional sense, not biopics, because, you know, if we, for example, with a film like Azhar, if you're adding songs, if you're taking a bit of creative liberty in this, although we have a lot of facts on our side and, you know, things that have been documented and we put them in the film, it's kind of, I would say, a semi-biopic in nature. But it's a great trend because, you know, it also has a sense of realism in the film. Of something that's, you know, relative to someone's past. Like, for example, films like Airlift, and, you know, these are stories that have been lost in time. A film like Azhar is about a person who we've, you know, very closely followed, and it's the first biopic of its nature of someone who everyone has followed. So it's very interesting to know how the audience kind of laps it up and how you know, the interest levels are to a film like this. I'll call up and give wishes.
What are the things that attracted you on this
Azhar? What attracted me? The man's life journey. It's you know, it lends itself to some great cinema. You know, he's seen everything. This is struggling years before he became a cricketer. Great success, and then a terrible fall in year 2000 when everything was snatched away from him. When he was just about to complete his 100. Test matches, his career was taken away from him on 99. So he's, you know, he's short of that one test match, but the way we see it, he kind of was vindicated and he wins the 100th test match in the court when he wins the court case. So it's a beautiful story. It's kind of tragic also in many ways, because Azhar Bhai also lost his son close to the verdict of the case. But he's a very strong person. He's, you know, has a lot of will and inner strength, and that has got him through the entire phase. I don't know. It depends. You know, if I get a film of, I don't have anyone in mind in that sense. Not someone here though. I've always liked Lance Armstrong. I know Lance Armstrong's film won't come to me, but I've enjoyed reading his book. It's Not About the Bike. Again, a controversial figure. I'd want to see, as an audience member, to see that life play out on screen, because he had 7 world titles snatched away from him because of the, you know, obviously everyone knows about that. So that's a very controversial story. Yeah.
Imran, so you have done many great roles, and many intense and romantic roles. But how is Portugal? Actually, you are not in any controversy linked to any actress.
Yes.
So
He's a private person.
I'm very smart.
He's smart.
He's a good guy.
Actors should learn from that. Sorry? Yeah. We practiced for 3 months here. It was in Andheri. We used to practice and train every day for 3 months last year, Jan. It was the weather was better, so we used to start off at 9 in the morning. And Azerbaijan was always punctual at 9 in the morning. We used to train till 12. Those hours got shorter. By the time it was May, we used to sweat it out. We used to train only for an hour or two. But it was great, playing with him. And that was the toughest for me, because my wrists didn't move on like a 40 degree axis, and his was extremely, flexible. It took me 6 months training to get the wrists, the flick right. Well, the famous dialogue is, "Main teen cheezon ke liye famous hoon: ek khuda ko manta hoon, do shaadi hui hai meri, aur teen match fix karne ke ilzam hai mujh par."
No. We match our outfits every day.
It's coincidence.
It's coincidence.
I definitely didn't call Imran to say, "Hey, what are you wearing today? You know, you think we could
do a
matching outfit?"
Your stylist did.
Yeah,
your stylist.
No lie, August.
I know.
Don't you lie now. Uh-huh. Yeah. All right. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Are we going home?
Now what?
People.
Who's doing other tweeting?
I know.
Who's in charge? You're in charge?
Yeah.
Because you put an ugly picture of
me.
Yeah.
Oh,
you
just sing my song there.
I sang your song?
Yeah.
What song?
So
shiny? Yeah, you don't want a shiny picture, right?
Okay.
What song? No. I sang a song.
Okay. Yeah, that's my song.
Hey, you
better
take
a nice one.
One second.
Sentence
lift.
You better take a nice one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Thank you.
Thank
you. Thank you.
Thank
you. Thank
you.
Thank you.
बिल्कुल नजर रखता हूँ ऐसे फीवर से जा रहे फिल्म तो आप परिचित हैं लेकिन हमारा एक नया रेडियो स्टेशन आया है रेडियो नशा 91.9 FM
क्या इसका आपने चेंज किया
जी नहीं दूसरा रेडियो स्टेशन यहीं पर है जी हाँ दोनों घंटे बाकी 70s 80s 90s के जबरदस्त गाने होते हैं नए गाने हो पुराने गाने हो सिर्फ आपको ही दोष Yes, क्या बात है सही पकड़े हैं आप बहुत अच्छा मैं बता दूं कि अजहर के बारे में बहुत एक्साइटेड लोग यहाँ पर और सदा अजहर
क्रिकेट के क्वेश्चंस हैं या किस पे क्वेश्चन
आप किस पे चाहते हैं
किसिंग के पे क्वेश्चन
किसिंग के ऊपर
वो तो फिर मैं लास्ट टाइम ऐसे ही हुआ था ना यहाँ पे तो मेरा स्कोर अच्छा था उसमें
किसी के बारे में मुझे क्वेश्चन पूछे पड़ेंगे वो तो
ठीक है क्रिकेट पे क्वेश्चन
ओके चलिए आइए सबसे पहले ग्लेन सर अच्छा क्या बोलना ग्लेन से शुरू करते हैं ग्लेन
Honestly, Janna, craziest place you've made out.
Mike.
Come on. Bandra?
Are you talking about a place in Bandra?
In anywhere, please.
In the
so
world.
My record is in my own terrace.
Behind Pettit School here. You know that place that brought behind Pettit School?
Bandra, man.
Bandra, man.
So there. And building.
You know which alley I'm talking about, right?
Are you talking
about? It's Dine Pen, yeah. Would this be your parents' competition or ground
competition? And craziest place in your building?
Your building is the craziest place, but that's why I'm not that crazy. Okay, next. Sidhu, will you ask me?
Hi sir, Sidhu.
Hello ma'am.
Hi.
फिल्मों में बुकी से लेकर फिल्मों में क्रिएटर तक की जर्नी कैसी रही? बुकी से लेकर क्रिकेटर तक जर्नी कैसी?
Well actually जन्नत रिलीज हुई थी 6 साल पहले और उसमें भी एक
सर यहाँ पे
एक मैच फिक्सिंग का सबप्लॉट था उस फिल्म में तो I don't know why I get these only controversial parts of the sport of cricket लेकिन इसमें एक इंस्पिरेशन स्टोरी भी है अजहर में क्योंकि अजहर भाई ने हमारे देश को 10 साल तक अपने कैप्टनसी से जिताया एंड ऑफ कोर्स अनफॉर्चुनेटली 2000 में एक बहुत बड़ी कंट्रोवर्सी हुई थी तो जन्नत इज आई गेस वाज अ स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट वेयर आई वाज प्लेइंग द बुकी ये एक ऐसा डिमेंशन है क्रिकेट का जो अजहर भाई ने हमारे साथ शेयर किया लॉट ऑफ एनेक्डोट्स अबाउट द स्पोर्ट एक क्रिकेट की एक ऐसी दुनिया है जहाँ पे वी हैव सीन इट फ्रॉम a distance we have obviously loved the sport but we don't know about the conversations that take place in locker rooms kis tarah players ki gavrati kis tarah hai jokes kya hote hain chakre kaise hote hain obviously wo 12 saal tak match fixing controversy ke time pe in detail we have not seen that till now to jannat se leke azhar tak ek bahut hi achhi journey rahi hai and I always get this very unusual dimension of the sport which is match fixing but in this is also inspiration
wah madhya
okay abhi hai na thoda gk type question karne wali hu aapko aur agar aapne galat jawab diya then I'm going to give you a task to acche se sochna ab aap dono ka jo pair hai wo bada hi famous hai तो इसीलिए मैं आपको पूछने वाली हूँ कि वंस अपॉन अ टाइम इन मुंबई में प्राची देसाई के कैरेक्टर का नाम क्या था उनके लिए
मुमताज
ओ शिट
ओ
एक बार गलत जवाब दे देते इतना अच्छा टास्क था
अरे पूरा नाम था
No, there was a task, लेकिन अब उन्होंने सही जवाब दे दिया ना इसलिए
एक और क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं गलत जवाब देना यार
पानी जी आप ही पूछ लो ना
तीन डायलॉग ऐसे जो आप
क्यों वो डायलॉग खत्म हो जाता है उस दिन वो भूल जाता
है उसके बाद ऐसा मत करें अच्छा अजहर का एक डायलॉग बोल दो
अजहर उस तरह की डायलॉग वो एक ही है जो हमने प्रोमो में प्ले किया है मेरे नाम में ही मोहम्मद है तो ऐसे ऐसे थोड़े थोड़े पंच लाइन है लेकिन इट्स नो एलैबोरेट डायलॉग इस तरह क्योंकि स्पोकन होती है ओके
निशा
मैं बहुत डिफिकल्ट सवाल पूछने वाली
हूँ आपको देख के पता चल रहा है
बहुत ही डिफिकल्ट मोहम्मद अजरुद्दीन ने अपने पहले प्लीज गलत जवाब देना मोहम्मद अजरुद्दीन ने अपने पहले तीन टेस्ट मैचेस में हां
सही है
कौन से कलर के मोजे पहने थे
सफेद मैं अजहर भाई को फोन करूंगी इस पे आगे मत करना मेरे साथ मुझे पता है सफेद मोजे पहने थे
आपकी सजा क्या होनी चाहिए
लास्ट क्वेश्चन जो इन सब के लिए बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है क्योंकि बाद में मौका मिले ना मिले. ओके
तो क्या होता है कि ऐसे एक्टर के साथ काम करते हुए बहुत कुछ इंसान सीखता है, तो तुमने क्या सीखा है?
Is that the word you're waiting for? Imran ke saath kaam karke, okay, this is a little serious. Patience. I don't know how you know Imran is so patient, but I think patience is the one thing I've learned from him on this film.
क्या करते हो? किस चीज का पेशेंस? बहुत ऐसा लगता है कि क्या करूं?
You know, see these people are constantly trying and testing your patience. So I think वो जितने भी किसी retakes और जिसकी भी बात कर रहे थे इमरान, उसमें जो पेशेंस चाहिए, that is what I
think. राजी, जोरदार तालियां होनी चाहिए.
Today is the theatrical trailer launch, so without much delay, sir, sure. So please announce it.
Please. Yeah. Can we please have the trailer play out?
We have to go down.
And the real Azhar, you've seen the trailer. I hope you guys enjoyed it.
Azhar bhai, what led you to give us the green signal for this film? Why did you want us to make this?
That is a very tough ask. But actually, I really wanted to clarify the events which occurred in my life. Actually, the press has been calling it as a biopic, but I would like to stress that it is not a biopic. It is a film which is made on the events which have happened or occurred during my playing days at that point of time. I just wanted to clarify to the people that, you know, whatever has been said, you know, I've gone through a lot, you know, I mean, like, for so many years. It took 12 years to get to the case, and after that, when we won the case, then I thought when Ika approached me, you know, first of all, I was not very sure about it. But then I think it took a lot of persuasion from a lot of people. Then I discussed with so many people. I discussed with one of my best friends here, Anshul Bhai. I want to thank him also. I mean, he was very instrumental in me saying yes to that film.
And also, like you said, in 2011, the court gave you an acquittal.
2012.
Yes, 2012. They gave you the clean chit.
That's right.
But despite of that, there are still some critics and detractors. What would you want to tell them?
Well, I think you can't ask everyone to say good things about me. There are some people who are going to say things which are very ungainly or not very good to hear it. But I think it's part and parcel of life. You know, you have to take the good with the bad, and I think you have to move on.
Well, right now, I think we will call upon
The captain of the team, I think, Mr. Tony Anthony D'Souza. Without him, it would have been very, very difficult.
Hi. I've been a huge fan of Azarbai. I mean, known for quite some time. So when I got the offer of the film, I was very grateful to Ekta and Sneha for giving me the opportunity to make this movie. The person who's not here with us today is the person who actually written the script, Rajat Arora. Whatever you'll see and you'll like is thanks to him. I mean, he's worked the hardest and come up with a great script. I'd like to ask Azarbai to call the rest of the team on stage.
I think I'd like to call the two very pretty ladies, Prachi Desai and Nargis Fakhri. And I would like to call the most important lady who has taken me to the court, Lara Dutta.
First, I think since Prachi came in earlier.
Okay. Hi, guys. It's really exciting being here. And I think we've all been huge fans of Azhar sir. So it's wonderful being a part of a film where I get to play a real life character for the very first time for me. And I see Noreen as a very beautiful mystery that's going to unfold in front of you when you watch the film. So yes, I hope you guys enjoy it just as much as I did. And I love the trailer, I hope you guys did.
Okay, firstly, I have to apologize because I'm a little bit of a villain of the piece. So I think Tony couldn't find a villain, so I was made into one. I also think, I mean, this is my first film with Balaji, and of course my second with Tony, but my first with Imran. And I think at the end of this film, I am the only actress that he's worked with who he hasn't kissed. So, we shall
leave that. The one that got away.
The one that got away.
That's the secret that they get to know only once the film releases.
Yeah, you never know the other. Might be like never a surprise.
No. We'd like to call Mr. Sameer Nair on the stage. Ekta Kapoor, the most important lady. Without these two ladies, it would have been very, very tough. I would like to call upon my son also who is here. I mean, he's been a very integral. Would like to call Nargis Fakhri also, please.
So,
wait for 2 minutes. So
no, we'll just let's just open. Yeah, we'll open the house please. For questions.
Can we play Oye Oye till then?
देखिए बहुत सारे चैलेंजेस थे जब हम रिसर्च कर रहे थे तो ऑब्वियसली जब फ़ोन कॉल आया जब एकता ने मुझे फ़ोन किया तो मुझे बहुत खुशी हुई कि इन पे फिल्म बन इनकी लाइफ में फिल्म बन रही है. लेकिन तभी उसके बाद वो खुशी कहीं डर में बदल गई, क्योंकि इनकी लाइफ इतनी इवेंटफुल रही है. एक तो इम्बाइबिंग अ कैरेक्टर ऑन स्क्रीन, जो फिल्म देखने वाले हैं जिस तरह बात करते हैं, जिस तरह चलते हैं, और जो मेन चीज़ थी वो थी उनकी क्रिकेटिंग स्किल्स. क्योंकि मैं इतना अच्छा क्रिकेटर नहीं हूँ, आई मीन हम सब इंडियंस हैं तो यहाँ पे बैट बॉल रख दो तो हम सब खेलें, यू नो वी स्टार्ट प्लेइंग इट. बट एक फॉर्म जो है, एक टेक्निकलिटी जो है, वो मुझ में नहीं था. लेकिन अज़र भाई हैज़ बीन वेरी पेशेंट, उन्होंने मुझे 2-3 महीने तक ट्रेनिंग दी एंड ही मेड इट अ लॉट ईजियर.
अज़र सर
जी बोलिए.
हेलो 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 अज़र सर, आपसे सवाल है इधर आपके स्ट्रेट सीधा. अज़र सर इधर.
He's the one in the India.
Yes,
India.
Yeah, India.
Yeah, T-shirt.
कहाँ पर?
अच्छा, बहुत दूर है.
Hong Kong.
अच्छा सर, सबसे पहला सवाल आपसे है कि आप सफेद हेलमेट क्यों पहनते थे? इसका जवाब चाहिए. सेकेंडली एक सवाल और है कि एक शॉट आपका है जो आप फ्लिक करते थे, क्या कहते हैं उसको, जो VVS लक्ष्मण भी खेलते हैं लेफ्ट लेग ड्राइव पे, तो वो शॉट आपने ट्रेलर में नहीं दिखाया हमें, तो वो शॉट क्या फिल्म में होगा आपके?
देखिए, पहली बात तो वाइट हेलमेट इसलिए मैं पहनता था क्योंकि उस टाइम पे हमें जो भी हेलमेट मिलती थी हम पहन लेते थे. उस टाइम पे कोई ऐसा रूल नहीं था कि ब्लू हेलमेट ही पहने या और कोई अलग हेलमेट पहने, तो इसी वजह से मुझे सफ़ेद कलर अच्छा लगता था क्योंकि सफ़ेद कपड़े होते थे, सफ़ेद जूता होता था, सफ़ेद पहतावे होते, सफ़ेद पैंट, सफ़ेद ग्लव्स, तो उसकी वजह से मैं सफ़ेद हेलमेट पहनता था. बट लेकिन जो आप फ्लिक शॉट के जो बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, मुझे याद नहीं है मैं मुझे कैसे खेलता था, मुझे मैं तो भूल गया हूँ. लेकिन आप जब फिल्म में देखेंगे तो शायद इमरान भाई मेरे से अच्छा खेल रहे हो.
एक्चुअली वो फ्लिक शॉट है, इट गोज बाय वेरी फास्ट. टोनी यू सेकंड दैट. अगर आप फास्ट कट्स देखें एंड में, एंड ऑब्वियसली इन द फिल्म इट्स इट हैज अ बिट ऑफ लेंथ.
इमरान यस, इमरान
यस,
ऑन योर लेफ्ट, सॉरी इमरान टुवर्ड्स योर राइट.
या
हाय,
यस हाय.
The trailer really looks amazing, you know. Thank it has you. A mix of everything, basically what you all want to show through his life and through his journey till now.
Yes.
What has been your family's reaction to the trailer, to your look?
Well, they're going to see it. They're going to see, everyone's going to see it soon. But I'm sure they're going to love it because like you said, it has everything in it. It has, you know, the look of the film, the emotion. And this is where we were, actually this was a huge responsibility on, I think, the entire team, that we were putting his life down on celluloid, and that's a huge responsibility. Eventually, you know, there is an audience for whom we're making the film, but for me, it would be a battle won if, whenever Azhar Bhai sees the film, when the lights dim in the theater, and he watches the film and he comes out and says, you know, you've done me proud, and this is how I would envision my life. That would be the best, you know, bit of praise that I can get for the film. So I'm waiting for that day when he sees the first copy, which will be out soon.
Imran,
I would like to call upon Nargis Fakhri on the stage, please.
Imran, what was that one lesson you learned from Azhar's life?
I think apart from the film, it's just when I met him, obviously I have idolized him for the longest time. You know, I'd seen him in the 80s and 90s. And what struck me when I met him, and you know, we were doing the research and I had actually compiled 100 questions for him. And I used to keep bugging him every day with these questions. And I just felt that here there was a man who was extremely frank about the way he has been, he's led his life. And, you know, it's just, sometimes you want to see yourself the way you want to see yourself, not in reality. And he was extremely cordial. He was extremely frank about those things and a very, very sensitive person. Those are the things I admire about Azhar Bhai. And I've spent a lot of time with him over the past 1.5 years. And a lot of things can be said, but these are the two things, a very frank person and a very sensitive person.
And any similarity you find between you and Azhar Bhai?
Well, I've tried to imbibe the similarities. I don't know.
Flick shot.
That was the toughest, actually. My wrists, I had to ice them every day because it was very tough. I used to work out. I used to lift weights and became, because Azhar Bhai used to not lift weights. He said that he's against that
when I was playing.
When you were playing at that time.
and there was a certain agility and a flexibility. So I had to like detrain for like 3 months and just train to get that flick shot. So it took me 4 months to get that. So it was almost a choreographed action, and we eventually got it.
Hi.
I think it's been pretty long time now, so I don't blame anybody. I think that it was destiny which had me on the mat. But anyways, to come out of that, you know, it was very, very pleasing. I was very happy for my family, for my son, my father, my mother, everybody, and all the fans, all the people who really, helped me in whatever way they can. They came in hordes to watch the matches, and I think I felt that, you know, it was the right thing when I went to the court, when we won the case. That was icing on the cake. Okay. Imran shares seasoning chemistry with everybody.
I sizzle with everyone.
There's not a problem. There's nothing new for him. Ask me something new. Well, I think with Imran Hashmi, actually it's not a love-making scene, you know, it was and pretty, I think it was a very tough thing to say. But anyways, with Imran Hashmi, you expect that. You know, if you go there and Imran Hashmi is not doing that, I mean, you will come out very disappointed.
Hi, Ekta.
Don't you reckon?
Hi, Ekta, over here, towards your right. Ekta, towards your right, over here. Many players, towards your right, over here. Are you planning to keep a special screening of the film for the cricket team or the players who... played under Azhar sir?
So that's completely going to be decided later. But I'm sure we will show a lot of players the film because it's quite a celebration not only of cricket but of what happens when you are doing so well and suppose one game goes wrong, you get blamed for so many things. So yeah, a lot of cricketers will be seeing the film. But many don't want to see the film. I think many would not want to see the film. So yeah, that would be there too.
Antonio, you know, many other players were involved in this scandal. So, how much of importance has been given to them, their characters?
I think it's better that you watch the film and ask this question. I mean, we've gone, as he said, it is not a biopic, but we based on facts and events that happened in life. So, we've tried to go close to a lot of things, but there's certain cinematic liberty we've taken too.
Hi, Azhar.
But have you fictionalized the events? Is there anything fiction or?
See the movie. It'll make no sense that way.
Hi, Azhar.
देखिए मैं सबसे बात करके इस डिसीजन लिया कभी अकेला डिसीजन लेना देखिए बहुत मुश्किल होता है तो मैं कैप्टन हूं तो मैं पूरे 11 लोगों का पूरा व्यू पॉइंट लेके देख के उनसे बात करके तो जब भी डिसीजन लेना था आपको याद होगा कि 93 वर्ल्ड हीरो कप में हम लोग जब ने मैच साउथ अफ्रीका के साथ जीता था तो हमारी आप देखे थे लास्ट ओवर था 5 रन बाकी थे तो हमारी पूरी टीम जमा हो गई थी हमारी पूरी टीम का डिसीजन था कि तेंदुलकर बॉलिंग करना तो तेंदुलकर ने बॉलिंग किया तो मैं समझता हूँ कि सभी से एडवाइस लिया हूँ मैं तो इसी वजह से आज ये फिल्म आगे
हाय स्नेहा मेरा सवाल आपसे है कि आप आईपीएल के भी ब्रॉडकास्टर हैं तो इस फिल्म को आईपीएल के दौरान भी प्रमोट किया जाएगा वाइल कॉन्वर्सेशन जो होते हैं बीच में
जी बिल्कुल
तो क्या प्लानिंग है एग्जैक्टली किस तरीके से प्रमोट करेंगे
वॉच द आईपीएल यू विल सी
ओके इमरान यही ऑडी था जहां से शुरुआत हुई थी आई थिंक 6-8 महीने पहले जब पहला एक टीजर छोड़ा गया
था। जी
तब से लेकर के अभी तक का सफर जरा अगर आप बताएं कि किस तरीके से ओवरऑल क्योंकि आपने आईएसडी भी शूटिंग की है एसटीडी लोकल भी
आईएसडी ज़्यादा शूटिंग की है बट एक बहुत ही टफ जर्नी रहा है क्योंकि तभी तो हमने सिर्फ वॉक शूट किया था और बैक टू कैमरा शॉट था लेकिन उसके बाद वी केम डाउन टू एक्चुअली शूटिंग और हमने लंदन में शूटिंग की एच बेस्ट इन दाबिशर हैदराबाद में जो इनका होम टाउन है तो बहुत नर्वस था मैं क्योंकि यू नो क्रिकेटिंग पोर्शंस ऑब्वियसली वर दे मेड मी द मोस्ट नर्वस क्योंकि सब लोगों ने अज़हर भाई को देखा है उनके मैनरिज्म्स हैं ऑन द फील्ड उनके न्यूएंसेस हैं तो उन चीज़ों को एम्बाइब करना एंड अगर इस फिल्म में अगर आपने कुछ गलत कर दिया तो एक तरह से एक बहुत ही ज़्यादा क्रिटिसिज्म हो सकता है तो उस चीज़ को दिमाग में रखकर नोटिंग वेरी वेरी माइन्यूट थिंग्स अबाउट अज़हर भाई फ्रॉम द वॉक टू द वे ही इज़ टू ईट द वे ही इज़ टू स्पीक तो ये सब चीज़ें मैंने एम्बाइब करनी शुरू की ही हार्डली एट दैट्स व्हाई आई एम हार्डली ईटिंग इन द फिल्म ऑल्सो बट आई ऑलमोस्ट गेम इज स्टॉकर you know when we were actually playing cricket I think he caught me staring at him eerily and trying to just see what, you know, everything, every nuance. So I think I made his life hell for those 3-4 months.
एक खास लहजा भी है हैदराबाद का जो ट्रेलर में सुनाई
जी था। इसमें है पोर्शंस में है जो जब हैदराबाद का पोर्शन है इस फिल्म में जो उनके चाइल्डहुड से लेकर जब वो 20 के थे 21 थे तो वो पोर्शन में थोड़ा ज्यादा लहजा है
हैदराबाद नरगिस आपने वो ओए ओए वाला गाना सुना था पहले आप अगर हिंदी में
yes, I have.
तो उस समय और इस समय क्या क्या डिफरेंसेस अगर आप बता सके ऑन योर राइट
सॉरी व्हाट डिड यू से अगेन
मैंने हिंदी में पूछा कि उस गाने में इस गाने में कितना परिवर्तन है तब्दीलियां हैं
व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस एज इन वॉच द फिल्म एंड यू विल फाइंड आउट वेरी गुड थैंक यू सो मच
सब कुछ अगर फिल्म देख के ही पता करेंगे तो फिर आज कुछ आपसे भी तो पूछना चाहेंगे
हाय टोनी मेरा सवाल आपसे है आप इस टैगलाइन पे फोकस करेंगे लव हिम हेट हिम जज हिम इट्स जनरली लव मी हेट मी डू नॉट जज मी
Judge him because a lot of people still think that a lot of people are not aware of the verdict of the court. So the idea was to portray what is the fact actually happened with the court. So we are hoping that people see and they judge him the way they should judge him after the film.
Tagline की बात कर रहे थे तो आपसे जानना चाहेंगे love him hate him judge him ये ज़हन में कौन सी बात आती है जब ये tagline आपको सुनाया गया या जब आप सुनते हैं
love him नजीम ही आएगी और दूसरी तो कोई दिमाग में आ रही नहीं आपने इतना
इमरान जन्नत
सवाल था
इमरान आपने जन्नत में मैच फिक्सिंग का रोल किया था अभी आप रियल लाइफ हीरो का रोल प्ले कर रहे हैं तो आपकी लाइफ में क्रिकेट कितना इंपॉर्टेंट है
वेल बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट रहा है यू नो आई हैव ग्रोन अप वाचिंग अजहर भाई इन द 80s 90s जब वो कैप्टन थे एंड आई थिंक दोज वर द ग्लोरी डेज ऑफ क्रिकेट क्योंकि तभी ज्यादा फॉर्म्स भी नहीं थे एंटरटेनमेंट के And whenever your family used to sit and watch, there was this very concentrated approach that everyone used to sit and watch the match. Zala internet nahi tha, zala programs nahi the. So it was just a great time for cricket. Aur jab in India aur Pakistan ke matches bhi hua karte the. It was just very, very entertaining. So those are the memories of cricket. And obviously cricket is still great. But I was very honored jab mujhe ye role mila to portray his life.
Imran, there were reports that your family was not happy with the first poster.
No, that's not true. Like I gave the quote today, maybe it was misconstrued when I said they were shocked. That doesn't mean they didn't like it. They were surprised and in a nice way because that's what I my wife told me in the morning. She loved the poster. She found it very unique and she said she definitely wants to see the film.
Imran, Indian team ki blue jersey pehenne ke baad kya kuch mehsoos kar rahe the aap?
Very proud.
Imran, here. Imran, when this match fixing scandal broke out way back in the 90s and when Azhar's name got embroiled in it, what was your reaction? Did you at that time believe that Azhar is innocent?
No, I didn't. You see, the thing is, there is obviously there were fans of Azhar Bhai that gave him the support that he obviously deserved at that point of time. There are also certain people that like to jump the gun and play judge, jury and executioner when they say that, okay, probably he has done it. But they didn't even follow the court case and eventually it was kind of a vindication when he won the court case. So I believe in following a certain, you know, the way the law has to function, let it take its course. And that happens not just with him, it's happened with every celebrity, every sports person around the world. You know, it's very high profile and people do reach their own judgment, which I think is extremely unfair. You should let the court have its hearing and then decide. We might not agree with the court's verdict, but we have to accept it.
Okay. Azhar, cricket and Bollywood often go hand in hand with each other. We have seen many cricketers date Bollywood actors. One person who has been at the receiving end for dating a Bollywood actress is Virat Kohli, whose failure sometimes gets his girlfriend to the picture and criticism happens on social media. What would your advice be to him? How should he tackle it? How should he react to it?
I think the press should tackle better than what Virat Kohli should tackle because I think this is personal life, you know, because you cannot really, talk about all those things, you know, because I think he's performing well on the field. And as a player, you know, you really have to really look at what he's doing as a cricketer. I mean, his performance has been outstanding. And I think whatever he does in his private life, I think you have to leave it to him, you know, because sometimes we get too judgmental and then, I think that's what happened. I think if the things are true that there's some problem in the relationship, I think it's because of the tough time which is posed by the press to them.
Hi, Tony. Gaurav from Midday. I have two questions, one for you, one for Imran. On to your right, here, on the stairs. So, the first question is, you know, you have said the film is based on the facts and, you know, whatever it's been reported around Azhar Bhai. So, you know, there were a lot of, there are a lot of reports about, you know, players, basically team players revolting against him or the fights between him and the other players. And also about the political career which he had. So are we just going to see the, you know, the controversial side of it or, you know, just the fixing side of it? Or will there be some glimpses of, you know, all these things? And second question is for Imran. So if you want to answer this first.
Yeah, I think, you know, everyone talks only about the fixing. There's a lot more to his life than just fixing. I mean, he's the only person to score 100 in the first and last match, 300 in a row. We've got to celebrate him as a cricketer also. So the film is not only about a certain aspect in his life, it's the entire journey of life which has happened. As far as players who didn't support him or supported him, I think the film answers all that.
And for Imran, who do you think is, till now, who do you think is the best captain for Team India?
He's standing right here.
Thank you.
Imran, towards your left.
A little later.
Imran, towards your left. Mera sawal aapse is Taylor launch se thoda hat kar hai. Aapki close friend Kangna, she is celebrating the national award, but off late unki personal life ko lekar kafi kuch.
Can we just keep it to the film, please?
Just wanted to get your view because
too many personal lives are being spoken about.
One on one, we'll do it. Yeah?
Okay. Hi, Nargis.
Hi.
Loud. No, unfortunately, I didn't get to meet Sangeeta, but I did watch her films, and with the help of the team here, I learned about the stories that went on. And of course, we have the internet, so I can research now, which I love the internet. So I used all of that to imbibe her character. Oh, I did my best. I hope I did all right. Yeah.
Hi, Prachi.
Yeah, her Hindi's very good. Mine is not.
Her Hindi is also very good.
It's
Prachi.
Okay.
Prachi, here.
I want to understand. Samne. Yeah, what I want to understand.
Left side.
My left.
Right side. Sorry.
Right.
Samne.
Hi.
Hi, Anugya, News Online. Se. Mera sawal ye hai ki aap Azhar ji ki first drive se mile the. Aapko jab ye role diya gaya tha. Aur ye second film hai aapki Imran ji ke saath.
Yeah, it only gets better. जी मैं मिली हूँ नौरीन से एंड एक्चुअली ऑनेस्टली पहले मेरे लिए आई थिंक इट वाज अ लिटिल स्कैरी व्हेन आई गॉट टू नो दैट आई हैव टू प्ले नौरीन बिकॉज उनके बारे में कोई भी इंफॉर्मेशन कहीं पर अवेलेबल नहीं है सो यू नो आई हैड टू कम्प्लीटली रिलाई ऑन द सोर्सेस थ्रू ऑफकोर्स टोनी वट एवर दैट आई गॉट टू नो अबाउट हर बट उनसे मिलने के बाद ऑनेस्टली मेरे जितने भी प्रिजम्पशंस थे इट जस्ट गॉट क्लियर लाइक कम्प्लीटली एब्सोल्युटली So I think after meeting her, I'm completely in awe with her. I think she's way more a lovely person than I imagined her to be. And unki jitne bhi characteristics hai, I tried to imbibe them in the film. I mean, bahut sari cheeze thi jo mujhe lagi ki, jaise mujhe bola gaya tha ki wo bahut, I think shy hai, bahut kam bolte hain. Magar aisa nahi hai. I think she has a beautiful gaze. When she talks, and there were a lot of things that I observed, so I'm very glad that I actually got to meet her. And yeah.
आपकी second Hello. Film है ये इमरान जी के साथ.
जी.
तो कुछ experience share करना चाहेंगी. On set कैसे रहते हैं? Azhar जी. On screen Azhar जी.
On screen के जो Azhar हैं, I think he plays cricket gorgeously now. And I just think this film, his performance in this film is going to blow your mind. Absolutely, and उनके साथ काम करके this experience was even better because उनका जो sense of humor है और nasty हो गया है, so it was a lot of fun actually shooting with him. Yeah.
मेरा सवाल अज़र जी से है, जब आपका बुरा वक्त चल रहा था,
yeah, I can see you.
Hello, जब मतलब आप बोलते ना सफलता के समय तो सब साथ होते हैं, लेकिन जब आपका बुरा वक्त चल रहा था, तो किस क्रिकेटर ने आपको सपोर्ट किया और उनको आप पे विश्वास था? या कोई और पर्सन?
देखिए तीन लोग ऐसे थे जो मुझे टोटल सपोर्ट मिला जो राज सिंह साहब जो मेरे ख्याल में राज सिंह डंगरपुर साहब जो प्रेसिडेंट थे बोर्ड के उन्होंने बहुत मुझे सपोर्ट किया और कमल मुरारका साहब ने भी बहुत मुझे सपोर्ट किया और क्रिकेटर्स में कपिल पाजी ने सब में ज़्यादा मुझे सपोर्ट किया, तो मैं समझता हूँ ये तीन लोग उस वक्त में मुझे बहुत बहुत सपोर्ट किया और मैं उनका बहुत बहुत शुक्रगुजार हूँ। मैं अगर कितना भी शुक्रिया अदा करूँ, मैंने समझता हूँ कि उनका शुक्रिया अदा कर सकूँगा, क्योंकि उस वक्त बहुत टफ था, बहुत से लोग अगेंस्ट भी बोल रहे थे, बहुत से लोग अलग अलग किस्म की बातें हो रही थी, बट लेकिन ये तीन लोग ने मुझे सपोर्ट किया, मैं उनका बहुत शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ। और जो लोग सपोर्ट नहीं किया, देखिए ये तो अपना हर आदमी का एक पर्सनल नज़रिया होता है और मैं समझता हूँ उसको वहीं पे छोड़ देना चाहिए।
और घर में घर पे किसका सपोर्ट था आपको?
घर में तो पूरे जने सपोर्ट करेंगे,
सभी सपोर्ट,
घर तो ये तो बहुत आसान था।
और इमरान जी, आपको ये रोल जब मिला तो आपकी नींद उड़ गई कि मुझे अभी परफेक्ट दिखना है हजरत जी के जैसे?
जी डेफिनेटली, जैसे मैंने कहा कि इस फिल्म के लिए जब सब लोगों ने अजहर भाई को स्टडी किया 80s और 90s जब भी खेल रहे थे, मैंने भी स्टडी किया, तो अगर क्रिटिसिज्म आना है तो एक बहुत ही बड़ा क्रिटिसिज्म आ सकता है, तो लेकिन एक पूरी टीम का सपोर्ट था। आई वुडंट से आई हैव डन दिस ऑन माय ओन, बहुत सारे लोग थे, हमारी पूरी डायरेक्शन डिपार्टमेंट, द प्रोडक्शन, द कॉस्ट्यूम्स, ऑल दीज थिंग्स हेल्प्ड। और ऑब्वियसली जब ट्रेन कर रहे थे तो अजहर भाई भी थे, तो बहुत लोगों ने मेहनत की मेरे साथ एंड इवेंचुअली आपको दिख रहा है स्क्रीन पर। और ऑब्वियसली अब फिल्म देखेंगे तो आप वर्डिक्ट्स देंगे।
एकता जी से मेरा सवाल है कि आपने इमरान जी को ही क्यों चुना इस रोल के लिए? मतलब इतने सारे इमेज के खिलाफ, मतलब खिलाफ जाके आपने चुना है, उनकी जो इमेज है तो कुछ खास दिखा आपने?
आई थिंक इमरान इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट अमेजिंग एक्टर्स आई वर्क विद, बहुत अच्छे उम्दा इंसान है और एक कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल येट गुड हार्टेड क्रिकेटर का रोल अगर कोई कर सकता है, and who has the mass India even today in love with him, it would have been one of the Khans or Imran. So we chose Imran.
Tony,
I think it's a bit of a blessing but as well as a backstep, because at the end of the day everybody has references to draw and I didn't. But I know at the end of the day I'm playing a prosecuting lawyer, and we were talking about Imran's sizzling chemistry with all the women. So I think I'm the only one who took him literally from the frying pan into the fire in this film. So sizzling he's really felt, right? It's come from this way. I think Tony helped a lot. We went over a lot of the information that related to the case. We really sat down and observed people within the profession. And, you know, I had a very clear character graph to play. Like I said, I literally do play a capital word that you don't say in public but starts with a B. And so she is somebody who's very sort of hard-hitting. And I think it was more challenging for me because she asked the questions that I think millions of Indian fans want to ask of Azhar. So through this film, she's that voice, and that was a huge responsibility.
Tony, trailer mein ek scene hai, excuse me. Tony, इसमें एक सीन है जिसमें पाकिस्तान की टीम को आपने दिखाया है कि इधर आजा भाई, तो कहते मेरे नाम में मोहम्मद है, तो कहीं ना कहीं ऐसा नहीं लग रहा पाकिस्तानी टीम की नाराजगी झेलनी पड़ सकती है और मैदान का एक दिखाने की कोशिश हुई है?
मैं नहीं मानता हूँ, मैं पाकिस्तान का भी फैन हूँ ऑन द क्रिकेट फील्ड, तो मैं ये नहीं चाहूंगा कि कोई हमसे नाराज हो, बट इट्स ऑल इन गुड ह्यूमर।
हाय लारा, लारा आपने आतिब मेंशन किया कि आप इमरान हाशमी की इकलौती ऐसी हीरोइन हैं जिन्हें उन्होंने किस नहीं किया है, आप खुश हैं या दुखी हैं?
नो नो, आई एम क्वाइट ऑल राइट।
आप उनके हस्बैंड से पूछिए।
यू हैव टू हैव समथिंग टू लुक फॉरवर्ड टू, राइट, इन फ्यूचर फिल्म्स दैट यू डू, सो वी विल सी।
इमरान हाशमी साहब की तो कलरफुल कहानी है इनकी, आपको तो पता है।
इमरान अजहर भाई,
सीन्स बहुत अच्छे रहेंगे।
अजहर भाई, इमरान
अजहर टुवर्ड्स योर राइट,
अजहर का तो ट्रेलर हमने सबने देखा, सबको पसंद आया, बट साथ ही में सुशांत सिंह स्टारर एमएस धोनी बायोपिक भी रिलीज हो रही है, तो कह सकते हैं एक ही जो क्रिकेटर के लाइफ पर बेस्ड फिल्में हैं दो आ रही हैं, तो कंपटीशन हो सकता है आपस में?
कंपटीशन देखिए वो अलग फिल्म है, ये अलग फिल्म है, ठीक है, बिल्कुल अब कंपैरिजन नहीं कर सकते। मैं जहाँ तक है मैं सोचता हूँ कि कंपैरिजन नहीं होनी चाहिए, बिकॉज देखिए उन्होंने अपनी फिल्म बना रहे, हम हमारी फिल्म बनाए, तो हम हमारी फिल्म के बारे में बात करेंगे ताकि उनकी फिल्म
अजहर
Azhar, towards your right. Azhar, here. This year, as we have two biopics, you know, on cricketers, on you, and then we have on MS Dhoni. Right. Any other cricketer whose life you think can be an interesting thing to watch? Maybe someone of your times or from the current crop of cricketers?
I'm not thinking on those lines, so it's very hard for me to say. Well, after my this thing, you know, it's very hard for me to find out whose life should be shown on the screen. I really don't know. It depends on the individual, you know, to be very honest. नहीं देखिए आजकल बिल्कुल प्लेयर्स जिम्मेदार हैं उन लोगों को पता है क्या है कैसे अपने आप को बिहेव करना तो मैं समझता हूँ मेरे को उतनी ज़्यादा कहने की ज़रूरत नहीं पड़ी
एकता
व्हाट वाज सो स्पेशल अबाउट दिस फिल्म दैट सोनी एंड
इधर भी एंड माय क्रिकेट आल्सो Hansi Kroni has passed away, so it is not very imperative for me to talk on those lines, you know, because I think he was a very outstanding player, you know, he's done so much for his country. I think he's still one of the most successful captains South Africa has ever produced. So, I mean, I think may his soul rest in peace. That's what I can say, because it's not very easy for me to say on that count. Well, I'm sure you would have seen, you know, but I think on his live film, I mean, he had to decide, I mean, if he was alive, so. Well, you have to find out on those, you know, I can't reveal, I mean, like,
Ekta,
I really cannot reveal anything.
Sorry. Ekta, do you think Pakistan will release this film? Because there are references to Pakistan, and every time there is a reference to Pakistan, they get very jittery. Like, for instance, it happened in Neerja and a lot of other films. How do you see it?
So, every serial of mine releases in Pakistan and does better there. So I don't think there'll be a problem because I don't think there's one reference against Pakistan. So except for what you saw in the promo, which is not really a reference against Pakistan, I think Pakistan will revel in this film because it's about cricket and it's about a loved cricketer who's been loved universally.
Who is that Pakistani player who invites Azhar to get into
match? What? No. No. Neha, no. Take this.
No,
समीर आप कुछ समीर आप कुछ बताइए आपकी क्या एक्सपेक्टेशन है फिल्म से
समीर कम टुगेदर अबाउट अजर व्हाट वाज द वन स्पेशल थिंग फॉर व्हिच सोनी एंड बालाजी हैव कम
टुगेदर वेल एक्चुअली एवरीथिंग अबाउट अजर इज स्पेशल आई मीन ही हैज बीन वन ऑफ इंडियाज फाइनेस्ट क्रिकेटर्स वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सक्सेसफुल कैप्टन्स वी हैव ऑल बीन बिग फैंस ऑफ हिज वी हैव ग्रोन अप सीइंग हिज मूवीज Tony is a big fan of his, Imran is a big fan of his, and you know, if a movie has to be made, this is a story that has to be told. And that's what we are doing, we are telling that story. And it's the most exciting, interesting story. So, I mean, I'm really happy that Balaji and Sony got together and got Tony and Imran and are telling others' life.
Well, I think at that time I was supremely fit at that point of time, you know, when I played my last test match, you know, I must not be saying about myself, but I think I used to really compete with the people who are 10, 12 years younger than me. So maybe I could have played another couple of years, but I think 99 test matches, I don't think anybody would break that. So, 99, one test match, anybody can be played. I'm not sure, maybe. I can't say.
Guys, last two questions, please, before we wrap up.
Of course, yes, of course. I've still not recovered from the loss last night. Well, I think it's going to be a very tough match. You know, I'd say 60-40 in favor of West Indies. I think after tomorrow is the game. I think West Indies really played well, you know, I think they deserved to be the winners last night.
Is that it? Okay, thank you guys. Photo op now.
Mubarak.
हेलो
रुक जाओ यार नरगिस
Nargis, left, left,
left, left, left,
left, left, left,
left, left, left, left, left,
left, left, left,
left, left, left, left, left, left,
So you're not doing it first?
Here we go. Start. 5 minutes.
Wake up.
Silent, please.
Hi, we have.
I like this square light.
We have Imran.
Me 2 years back, and Ikta had called me up, and it was a brief conversation where she said that we are planning out a film based on the life of Muhammad Azharuddin. And I didn't think for a second. I said, I'm definitely doing it. I didn't hear the story out because I followed him for those 15, 16 years when he was in our team. And when he was the captain of the Indian cricket team. And then after that, the unfortunate dark phase of Indian cricket and his life when his name was taken, when there was the match fixing allegation drawn on his name. So that was the conversation, and you know, after that we drafted the script. It took around a year after that, and we went on floors. Azhar Bhai actually had not okayed the script back then. He okayed it on the third draft, and then we finally went on floor and shot the film. Well, you know, if you're doing a fictional film, there is 100 different ways you can play a character. But when you're playing a film based on someone's life, who's, you know, alive, flesh and blood, people have followed him, you have to be very accurate and as close to home as possible. But in a film of this nature, it was very essential to dramatize certain elements. There were the 4 or 5 songs. So yes, it has elements of being a biopic, but at the same time, it dramatizes some moments for our audience to kind of, you know, to entertain them, because as part of our culture, the songs have to be there. And, you know, there are dialogues that people are going to love in this film. So we've dramatized it, I would say, 10 to 20%. But most of it is things about cricket that all of you don't know and that have been shared by Azharbhai with us. You know, they might have come out in the media, a lot of things, but not everything. So Azharbhai has shared those very, very intimate details about the sport and his life for this film. He's a fantastic person. He's got extreme amount of patience and inner strength to deal with the stuff that he went through in his life at that point of time. After, you know, being removed from the sport and the team in year 2000, when he was at the top of his game, I think it takes a lot of courage and inner strength and patience to deal with what he had to deal with. Yeah, come. No, come. Kursi lagi hum. I thought you guys were gonna take like half an hour like before, so I said.
Yeah. Have you been having coffee?
No, it's like the air.
A lot of things of others have been depicted in this biopic. So I think the match fixing concept also is what's depicted.
Yeah.
So do you believe that match fixing is going on in reality or not?
Well, I can't speak for a particular time in the sport, and at that time, you know, a lot of things were put forward. Eventually, it was the judicial system that had played out its, you know, the verdict, and he was acquitted of it. But sports around the world, you know, they have, hi, how are you doing?
Hi.
They have allegations that have been attached to it of match fixing, and that is a fact. Now, I can't come down to telling you which players fix matches. I can't tell you which games have been fixed, because that, you know, anyone's guess. I said it.
Sir, does spring cricket or practice cricket was
hurting? It was the toughest in this film, because coming very, you know, even close to the way Azharbhai used to play is extremely tough. You know, the most accomplished batsman was the highest run scorer at one point of time, and I was like an average to below average player. So not too much technicality, which was obviously thanks to Azharbhai. He taught me these things. I was more of an offside player. I had to play on the leg side, because that's where Azharbhai was very strong. So it took me around 3-4 grilling months of training for cricket every day, 3 hours every day. So yeah, so that's, you know, that was the regime back then.
I am unfortunately the only one who has not met anyone, so I didn't get compliments.
As yet.
Let's see.
To come soon.
To come soon. Everyone, you know, really enjoyed it. I liked it. I think they remixed it really well and made it more dancey and modern. So.
I played Noreen in the film. Noreen was Azhar's first wife. I think she was barely 16 when they got married. It was an arranged marriage. I think that's a side, that's a part of Azhar's life that not many know about. They do know that she was his first wife, but nothing more than that. So in this film, I think you get to, you know, see that part of his life. And I think the way it's been treated, and I just feel like everybody's going to be able to connect to it, because I did in a big way. And a lot many things actually about their relationship, about the 9 years of their marriage, which of course, like I said, nobody knows much about. I think that you get to see in the film.
This is your second film you think much, so are you afraid of...
Am I afraid of him? Yeah, you know, I usually don't sit this close to Imran. I'm a little scared. I'm afraid of Imran. Okay, no. Am I still afraid of him? That's your question.
He's been 40 interviews since then.
Okay, we're kidding. This happens after too many interviews. This is what happens. This is my second film with Imran, and it was a great experience. I think the familiarity really helped both of us, because yes, we play these real life characters. I think it was extremely tough for Imran to play Azhar for a lot many reasons. I mean, I know how hard he worked on this film, and Noreen for me. So just the fact that we were familiar with each other, we share a great rapport, all of that really made it much easier for both of us, and I had a great great experience working with him again.
Yeah, I mean, this is a trend that actually started off a couple of years back. I keep saying this, you know, the films here are, in the traditional sense, not biopics, because, you know, if we, for example, with a film like Azhar, if you're adding songs, if you're taking a bit of creative liberty in this, although we have a lot of facts on our side and, you know, things that have been documented and we put them in the film, it's kind of, I would say, a semi-biopic in nature. But it's a great trend because, you know, it also has a sense of realism in the film, of something that's, you know, relative to someone's past. Like, for example, films like Airlift, and, you know, these are stories that have been lost in time. A film like Azhar is a film is about a person who we've, you know, very closely followed, and it's the first biopic of its nature of someone who everyone has followed. So it's very interesting to know how the audience kind of laps it up, and how you know, the interest levels are to a film like this. I'll call up and give wishes. Right.
What are the things that attracted you on this road?
What attracted me? The man's life journey. It's you know, it lends itself to some great cinema. You know, he's seen everything. This is struggling years before he became a cricketer, great success, and then a terrible fall in year 2000 when everything was snatched away from him. When he was just about to complete his 100 test matches, his career was taken away from him on 99. So he's, you know, he was short of that one test match, but the way we see it, he kind of was vindicated, and he wins the 100th test match in the court when he wins the court case. So it's a beautiful story. It's kind of tragic also in many ways, because Azhar Bhai also lost his son close to the verdict of the case. But he's a very strong person. He's, you know, has a lot of will and inner strength, and that has got him through the entire phase. I don't know. It depends. You know, if I get a film of, I don't have anyone in mind in that sense. Not someone here though. I've always liked Lance Armstrong. I know Lance Armstrong's film won't come to me, but I've enjoyed reading his book. It's Not About the Bike. Again, a controversial figure. I'd want to see, as an audience member, to see that life play out on screen, because he had 7 world titles snatched away from him because of the, you know, obviously everyone knows about that. So that's a very controversial story. Yeah.
Yes. What is the secret?
He's a private person.
I'm very smart.
He's smart.
He's a good guy.
Actors should learn from that. Sorry? Yeah. We practiced for 3 months here. It was in Andheri. We used to practice and train every day for 3 months last year, Jan. It was the weather was better, so we used to start off at 9 in the morning, and Azhar Bhai was always punctual at 9 in the morning. We used to train till 12. Those hours got shorter. By the time it was May, we sweated out. We used to train only for an hour or two, but it was great, you know, playing with him. And that was the toughest for me, because my wrists didn't move on like a 40 degree axis, and he was extremely, you know, flexible. It took me 6 months training to get the wrists, you know, the flick right. Well, the famous dialogue is, main teen cheezon ke liye famous hoon, ek khuda ko manta hoon, do shaadi hui hai meri, aur teen match fix karne ke ilzaam hai mujh par.
Thank you.
No, 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 we match our outfits every day.
It's coincidence.
It's coincidence.
I definitely didn't call Imran to say, hey, what are you wearing today? You know, you think we could
your stylist did.
Yeah?
Yeah, your stylist.
No lie, Nargis.
Don't you lie now. Yeah, all right, thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Are we going home?
Now what?
Who's doing other tweeting?
I don't know.
Who's in charge? You're in charge?
Yeah.
Because you put an ugly picture of
it. Sing my song, man.
I sang your song?
Yeah.
What song? So shiny? Yeah, you don't want a shiny picture, right?
Okay.
What song? I sang a song.
Okay. Yeah, that's my song.
मैम हो गया आपका मेरा पीछे
सेंटर
में लिफ्ट
मैम
सेंटर यो
तेरा पीछे
मैम यो
कैमरा
मैम यो
आप परिचित नहीं है लेकिन हमारा एक नया रेडियो स्टेशन आया है रेडियो नशा 91.9 FM
क्या इसका आपने चेंज किया
जी नहीं दूसरा रेडियो स्टेशन यहीं पर है जी हाँ दोनों घंटे बाकी 70s 80s 90s के जबरदस्त गाने होते हैं नए गाने हो पुराने गाने हो सिर्फ आपको ही
बहुत सारा है ना वो यो एक प्ले करूंगा
यस क्या बात है सही पकड़े हैं बहुत अच्छा है मैं बता दूं कि अजहर के बारे में बहुत एक्साइटेड लोग यहाँ पर और सदा अजहर
क्रिकेट के क्वेश्चंस हैं या
किस पे क्वेश्चन आप किस पे
चाहते हैं
किसिंग के ऊपर
वो तो फिर मैं लास्ट टाइम ऐसे ही हुआ था ना यहाँ पे तो मेरा स्कोर अच्छा था उसमें
किसी का नहीं फिर मुझे क्वेश्चन पूछने पड़ेंगे वो तो
ठीक है क्रिकेट पे बस
ओके चलिए आइए सबसे पहले ग्लेन सर अच्छा क्या मतलब ग्लेन से शुरू करते हैं ग्लेन ओ ओ मैं दो क्रिकेट पे पूछने
वाला नहीं हां क्या
पूछेगा ऑनेस्टली जानना क्रेजी स्पेस यू मेड आउट
माइक माइक माइक
कम ऑन Bandra, Bandra.
Are you talking about a place in Bandra?
Anywhere, please.
In the world.
My record is in my own terrace.
Behind Pettit School, yeah. You know that place that road behind Pettit School?
Bandra, man. Bandra, man.
So there. And building. You know which alley I'm talking about, right?
Are you talking about?
It's right behind, yeah. Would this be your Pettit School? Right. Which, ground
is. And craziest place in your building? Or in there?
The building is the craziest place, but that's why I'm not that crazy.
Okay, next. Sidhu, will you push that again?
Hi sir, Sidhu.
Hello ma'am.
Hi. फिल्मों में बुकी से लेकर फिल्मों में थिएटर तक की जर्नी कैसी रही बुकी से लेकर क्रिकेटर तक जर्नी कैसे?
Well, actually, जन्नत रिलीज हुई थी 6 साल पहले और उसमें भी एक मैच फिक्सिंग का सबप्लॉट था उस फिल्म में. तो आई डोंट नो व्हाई आई गेट दिस ओनली कंट्रोवर्शियल पार्ट्स ऑफ द स्पोर्ट्स क्रिकेट. लेकिन इसमें एक इंस्पिरेशन स्टोरी भी है अजहर में, क्योंकि अजहर भाई ने हमारे देश को 10 साल तक अपने कैप्टनसी से जिताया. एंड ऑफकोर्स अनफॉर्चुनेटली 2000 में एक बहुत बड़ी कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी हुई थी. तो जन्नत इज आई गेस वॉज अ स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट वे आई वॉज प्लेइंग द बुकी. ये एक ऐसा डिमेंशन है क्रिकेट का जो अजहर भाई ने हमारे साथ शेयर किया. लॉट ऑफ एनिकडोट्स अबाउट द स्पोर्ट. एक क्रिकेट की एक ऐसी दुनिया है जहाँ पे वी हैव सीन इट फ्रॉम अ डिस्टेंस. वी हैव ऑब्वियसली लव द स्पोर्ट बट वी डोंट नो अबाउट conversations that take place in locker rooms, kis tarah players ki camaraderie kis tarah hai, jokes kya hote hain, chakre kaise hote hain. Obviously wo 12 saal tak wo match fixing controversy ke time pe in detail we have not seen that till now. To jannat se leke azhar tak ek bahut hi achhi journey rahi hai and I always get this very unusual dimension of the sport which is match fixing, but in this is also inspiration.
Wah, Madhya.
Okay, अभी मैं थोड़ा जीके का एक क्वेश्चन करने वाली हूँ आपको, और अगर आपने गलत जवाब दिया then I'm gonna give you a task, तो अच्छे से सोचना. अब आप दोनों का जो पेयर है वो बड़ा ही फेमस है, तो इसीलिए मैं आपको पूछने वाली हूँ कि वंस अपॉन अ टाइम इन मुंबई में प्राची देसाई के कैरेक्टर का नाम क्या था उनके लिए?
मुमताज.
एक बार गलत जवाब दे देते, इतना अच्छा टास्क था.
अरे क्या बात है, पूरा नाम बता.
No, there was a task, लेकिन अब उन्होंने सही जवाब दे दिया. Now he's
not. एक और क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं? गलत जवाब देना यार.
पानी जी आप ही पूछ लो ना.
तीन डायलॉग ऐसे हैं जो आप
क्यों वो डायलॉग खत्म हो जाता है उस दिन वो भूल जाता है उसके बाद.
श्योर ऐसा मत. अच्छा अजहर का डायलॉग बोल दो.
अजहर उस तरह की डायलॉग नहीं है, वो एक ही है जो हमने प्रोमो में प्ले किया है मेरे नाम में ही मोहम्मद है. तो ऐसे ऐसे थोड़े थोड़े पंच लाइन है लेकिन इट्स नो एलैबोरेट डायलॉग इस तरह, क्योंकि स्पोकन बुक है. ओके
निशा
मैं बहुत डिफिकल्ट सवाल पूछने वाली
हूँ. आपको देख के पता चल रहा है.
बहुत ही डिफिकल्ट. मोहम्मद अजरुद्दीन ने अपने पहले प्लीज गलत जवाब देना. मोहम्मद अजरुद्दीन ने अपने पहले 3 टेस्ट मैचेस में कौन से कलर के मोजे पहने थे?
सफेद. मैं अजहर भाई को फोन करूंगी इस पे आगे मत करना मेरे साथ, मुझे पता है सफेद मोजे पहने थे.
Don't do this.
मुझे मालूम बहुत अच्छा गाती हूँ
और फिर इसके बाद
ये मौका बार बार नहीं मिला।
कभी अपना मुंह नहीं दिखा पाऊं।
इतने टैलेंटेड लोगों के बीच में कभी और परफॉर्म नहीं कर पाओगे। प्लीज गा गाना गा एक गाना ही गाना यही मौका है।
ओके हु इज नेक्स्ट हु हैज टू आंसर अनदर क्वेश्चन कम ऑन
ओके मिस लेले ओके मिस लेले के लिए बात बोलना ओके बाय
सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है मेरे पास आपके लिए और आई थिंक आपको इसका आंसर मालूम होगा। आपके पूरे करियर में आपने कितने किसेस किए हैं?
रीटेक्स को लेकर या
नहीं सिनेमा में इसके बहुत बड़ी फैन है।
ये आपकी बहुत बड़ी फैन है, इसने सब काउंट किया है तो आप झूठ नहीं बोल सकते और जो पढ़ते पे वही बताइएगा।
एक्चुअली इसका जवाब मुझे पता नहीं।
नहीं
पूछ तो आप बता नहीं। 150 आप पता है?
हाँ। आपने कितना बोला है? 150
बहुत क्लोज थे। सदा क्या
सदा लीजिए कितने सीन
बताइए सर उसके साथ उसकी सदा सुन लो उसके बाद बताइए डांस करना है।
मेरा फेवरेट गाना है आपने वो नौरीन का गेटअप देखा है उस पे आपको ओए ओए करेंगे तो कैसे लगेगा? अनफॉर्चुनेटली कोई डांस नहीं है पर एक और पीरू जैसा रोमांटिक ट्रैक जरूर है दोनों के बीच में।
ओके है ओके इसमें इमरान ने किस किया है पूरी फिल्म को?
ऑफ कोर्स इमरान है और ओए ये मत पूछा किसके साथ बिकॉज़ दैट्स दैट यू हैव टू फिगर आउट।
ओके ओके क्या बात है राशि लास्ट क्वेश्चन जो इन सब के लिए बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है क्योंकि बाद में मौका मिले ना मिले। ओके तो क्या होता है कि ऐसे एक्टर के साथ काम करते हुए बहुत कुछ इंसान सीखता है तो तुमने क्या सीखा है?
Is that the word you're waiting for? इमरान के साथ काम करके क्योंकि this is a little serious patience. I don't know how you know इमरान is so patient but I think patience is the one thing I've learned from him on this film.
क्या करते हुए? किस चीज का पैशन बहुत ऐसा लगता है कि क्या करूं
यू नो सी दीस पीपल आर कांस्टेंटली ट्राइंग एंड टेस्टिंग योर पेशेंस सो आई थिंक वो जितने भी किसी रीटेक्स और जिसकी भी बात कर रहे थे इमरान उसमें जो पेशेंस चाहिए दैट इज व्हाट
राजी जोरदार तालियां होनी चाहिए।
Yeah,
Prachi ji, right one.
Prachi ji, yeah.
Shastri.
Yeah. One, solo.